Nairobi Governor Mike Sonko will name his deputy Friday, a whole year after technocrat Polycarp Igathe left in a huff. And the deputy will be a woman, as he had earlier hinted in a list he had drawn up. A reshuffle is a must in any government. Even the president did a reshuffle in his cabinet. By Friday, I will name my cabinet and nominate the deputy governor, Mr. Sonko said. The governor has been on the spot over the delay in filling the deputy governor's post and the exodus among his cabinet members. In August last year, the governor drew up a list which featured four women, namely former Steria MP Margaret Wanjiru, corporate guru Agnes Kagura and lawyers Karen Nyamu and Jane Wiru. This was later in October whittled down to Ms. Nyamu and Ms. Wiru. However, nothing has happened since. Mr. Sonko made the revelation Wednesday, while reacting to Monday's resignation of his education executive Janet Muthoni Uko. The governor said he had approved the resignation of Ms. Uko. I have worked well with Ms. Uko. Resigning is her constitutional right. I have accepted it and she can do it even today, Mr. Sonko said. The embattled governor dismissed allegations by Ms. Uko that he was blackmailing her. Earlier, in her resignation statement released to the media, Ms. Uko maintained that she had had good working relations with the governor. However, the narrative seemed to change later during an interview. You know, there are people who behave like when they appoint you to a position it means so much, it's like they have married you, it's like they have given birth to you. That's not the situation. This is a job and the terms are very clear, Ms. Uko said.